TotalRock, being joined with the lovely guys from Floods.
Hi,
hello.
Hello, all. I'm in the middle. It's a Flood sandwich.
Yeah, the best
yeah.
one. You make an even sandwich now, though, because it was five, and you make it six, so...
It's an even sandwich, yeah, you're right.
Like a club sandwich.
Like a... Yes.
It's like you could be the bit of bread in the middle, and then you've got ingredients, chosen ingredients.
I want to be meat.
You can be meat.
Where you are at the moment, you're bread.
Sucks.
It does suck a little bit.
You have to make some sacrifices every now and again. I think that's all right.
Okay, moving on. You've just come out off your set.
Yeah.
Good response. How was the crowd?
Yeah, it was really awesome, actually. I was quite surprised at how many people were there and stuff, especially as Mastodon were on the same time as us as well. So,
we had people singing along and stuff. It was crazy. Like, it was good fun.
Actually the best show we've ever played.
Yeah?
Definitely.
Yeah.
I'd say that. I'd
go as far as saying that. Best show ever.
Awesome. T-shirts and stuff. It was good.
Oh, excellent. Obviously, this is part of the Red Bull Bedroom Jams that you won.
Gain the opportunity.
We've been told we're not allowed to say win because we gained an opportunity.
So. Right, okay. It's a funny phrase to have to say.
Yeah, really.
Basically, you did very well.
Yeah.
How was that whole experience? For people that are watching this that didn't know anything about Red Bull Bedroom Jams, does someone want to explain what the whole gist of that was?
Yeah, I can. Basically, you upload your video onto their Red Bull Bedroom Jams site, and then you get your fans to vote and comment and get your buzz up on the page, and then there's like a top 10, and then if you're number one of the top 10 on a Monday at 5, then you go and do a live show. Is like playing in a bedroom, which is pretty fun. And then of those, there's 15 bands that go through to do a live show, and 8 of those come and play the festivals, and we were one of those 8, which is pretty cool.
Yeah.
What did you do in your video to make it stand out from the rest?
We got naked.
I noticed this, yes.
Day for us, really, is what we do.
Is that how you tend to practice normally?
We always get bored of practice and just end up naked.
We get naked and play each other's instruments. That's pretty much what we do at practice.
I like how you're saying that you like to be naked, you're holding each other's hands there.
We're a very close band.
There's bromance here. There's bromance. Oh, look at that.
That's awkward.
Yeah. I'm getting a little bit concerned that I am part of this sandwich now. But still. I shall lie in it. What's up for you guys now then? Because the bedroom gem thing, is it coming to a bit of a close? Now you've gained the opportunity.
Yeah.
What now lies ahead?
We've still got Heavy Festival and Underage Festival, and then they pick like an overall winner out of something. I think we might have to do another live show. Again.
Is what they pick.
Yeah, we've still got that to do.
But in between them, we're off on tour on Tuesday. The band called Lynchway and A World Defined. First headline tour, I believe.
Yeah.
Excellent.
See how that goes. It'd be cool.
We're doing that album as well. Hopefully, it should be out in September, I think.
Yeah, September, October kind of time. And then we're going to do a tour with a band called Akoda, who are also doing the Red Bull Bedroom Jam, to tie in with promotion for that and stuff like that. So.
And have you finished? Is the writing all done for the album? You just got to go into the studio and record it, or?
Well, we've written 24 songs.
That's quite a lot.
Yeah. I don't do a lot of my time, so I just write songs.
I'm guessing you've got to kind of get squeeze that down.
Yeah, we're going to pick 8.
Yeah.
So, 8 and maybe like an intro / interlude testing. And we've got loads of B-sides as well. So, we're going to do that, release a couple of singles, test the water, see what happens, you know? I mean, either way, like, we've all written something that we're really proud of. And so, regardless of how good it does, I personally don't care. I'm happy with how it sounds. So, that's all good enough for me.
It's a good position to be in as well. It's better than having, like, 5 songs and, like, struggling to pick, like, the best. Like, and we're in, like, the lucky position. It's all going to... We're like recording it ourselves with like Joe's recording it, so it's just literally a case of churning out song after song and picking out the best ones, and they're all the best ones though, aren't they, guys?
They're all winning.
Excellent. How long have you guys been together? You're not a new band, are you? You've been around for a little while.
Yeah, like fairly new, middle age maybe.
I'd say like we have been a band as such since 2009, but we've only been in a band with the current lineup and current sound for the last year or so. So I gauge our. I mean, yeah, we've been playing together since 2009, but this lineup and the way that we sound, the way that we are, is just a year old. So.
Yeah. Okay. Cool. And are you, as we talked about, the bromance and are you worried about going on tour and getting on each other's nerves a little bit?
We do that all the time anyway. Like. He nearly quit the band last tour because he bought a hat and we made fun of him
for it. Do you like trilbies?
Yeah, I've been known to wear a trilby now and then.
Yeah, well, he bought one that was stupid, it looked stupid, and he said they were systematically abusing him, and he said that he wanted to leave the band, but he got over it eventually.
Really angry as well. It wasn't even like an annoyed angry, it was angry. Like, got a bit worried.
Honestly, though, like, because we're all pretty close, like, me and him used to live together, and now me and him live together, and
that's nice.
Yeah, we've known each other for years and years and years. However much we all piss each other off and get on each other's nerves and stuff, it's one of those things, like, you don't ever go, well, we're not friends anymore. It's always just kind of like, fine.
Don't take it personally. Yeah, you're going to get on each other's nerves, just kind of deal with
it. It's almost like having a brother, you know, you bully each other all the time kind of thing. It's that kind of relationship we have. We annoy each other, get on each other's nerves and stuff, but at the end of the day, we're all still like five best friends that just...
We're the five best friends that anyone could have.
What he said.
That's a new single to be released. No, it's not. I'm lying. It's Sunday, which means there's been 3 days of this Sonisphere Festival. Were you here for all of them? Or did you have to get here?
We were here on Friday, because we're in, not Friday, Saturday, yesterday. We're in Scotland on Friday, playing Tina Park.
Okay.
So yeah, we came down here yesterday.
And so, have you managed to see some bands, or are you doing it?
Yeah, we saw Weezer, amazing. First Weezer, Biffy Clyro, Yumi at Six, really good.
I saw All Time Low, Josh.
Yeah, I saw Sum 41 from like, side of stage, was crazy. Yeah, the 14-year-old me was just like jumping up and down inside. Like,
there were a lot of people there, going there for a bit of a recollection of what life used to be.
We were like, oh, they're not going to play Fat Lip, they're not going to play In Too Deep, so we just left, and then they started playing it.
Why are they not playing, though? That's stupid to think that.
They did play it. But that's irrelevant. They did play it.
The end.
Full stop.
Okay, and obviously today we've got Slipknot. Yeah, anyone into that?
And Limp Bizkit. Don't forget Limp Bizkit. We met Fred Durst earlier.
Really?
Yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
He's one of our friends now.
Yeah, we're best friends. Like, we're like exactly like that.
Excellent. Me and F and me, I just ignore it.
That's pretty cool. You're playing it hard. Playing hard to get.
Fred.
Yeah.
He won't leave us alone. Yeah. He was trying to go and hang out with all his.
I've only just met you. You know, you asked for my number. I politely gave it to you. Don't abuse the right.
Okay.
I think these guys bonded over stupid hats.
Yeah. Okay. Good. Before this gets into a big bullying fight, I'm gonna let you carry on and enjoy the rest of the festival.
Thank you.
Congratulations again on gaining the opportunity.
Yeah, gaining the opportunity.
With Rebel Bedroom Jams, and I look forward to seeing what happens in the near future.
Yeah. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.